Justice Secretary Menardo Guevara has given verbal orders to the Bureau of Corrections to temporarily suspend the processing of conduct-based sentence reductions. In a statement, the Justice Chief says the move is a precautionary measure and is in the interest of prudence. A task force will review the guidelines on the implementation of the Good Conduct Time Allowance or GCTA grant. This after the news on the possible release of convicted rapist and murderer former Calauan Laguna Mayor Antonio Sanchez broke out. Supreme Court Chief Justice Lucas Bersamin meanwhile says they are leaving the issue to the DOJ.
Dahil hindi namin pwedeng pangunahan sila kasi sarili nilang teritoryo yan. At kung mayroong hindi satisfied sa kanilang pagbabago, kung binago man yan, baka dumating pa sa amin. Oo. Pero ito ay petition ng mga dati na nakakulong. Okay, sinabi nila i-retract ninyo sa amin. Now whether that will apply to heinous to convicts of heinous crimes is not something that we can cover in that decision yet.
Last week, 200 inmates benefited from the GCTA system, according to Bucor. In June, the High Court ruled that the law should be applied retroactively or when cases took place before the measure was applied. But Senator Juan Miguel Zubiri has expressed concern on the negative effects of the GCTA. He says the law may be used by criminals to fake their actions and may revenge to those who filed charges and testified against them. Zubiri drafted amendments to RA 10592, making inmates convicted of heinous crimes not qualified to avail of the GCTA. Mai Bermudez, UNTV News and Rescue.